Welcome to this brief guide on how to use Immersive Reader in OneNote. Accessibility plays a key role in Microsoft's modern workplace suite, and in no place is that more present than in OneNote, where the Immersive Reader originated from. We're going to learn how to use that today. So as you can see in OneNote, I have some text. I've actually copied the entire script for the movie B-Movie from Jerry Seinfeld, and it's quite a lot of text and can be quite complicated to read or pay attention to at certain points. So I can use the Immersive Reader functionality to make this easier for myself. What I need to do is go to the ribbon and select the View tab. I will then be able to select the option for Immersive Reader, which will be found in the Tools area. When I click on that, my Immersive Reader will open up. This is going to take a couple of seconds to load just because there is a lot of text here. But once it's done, you'll notice that I have none of the chrome around the edge of my window, which makes it a little bit easier to read. But I have these options in the top corner where I can even customize this further, including the ability to adjust my text size, making it larger or smaller to suit my needs. I can also choose to decrease the spacing or increase the spacing as needed for myself as well. I even have a few different options for text. There's Comic Sans, which we are not going to use for this demo. I'm going to select Calibri. But I also have different themes, which I can utilize to customize the UI elements of the Immersive Reader to make it easier for my personal vision needs. I'll select the sepia theme here. Now, there's a couple of other options available to me in Immersive Reader. This one is the grammar tools, which allows me to potentially break words down into their syllables. As you can see here, the word impossible has been broken down into all of its syllables. This has been shown to improve comprehension by as much as 10%. I can also highlight particular words as well, such as my nouns and adjectives, as I've done here. I can also use labels should I need those, as opposed to the colors themselves. Then I can go to my reading preferences, such as line focus, which when I toggle this on will help me to maintain my attention across the individual lines that are being read. I can either have 1, 3, or 5 lines showing. I also have the ability to enable a translation tool into one of the many languages that Office supports, and I can choose to do this on a word-by-word basis or for an entire document. I'm going to select Word for this demonstration. So when I click on the word bees now, I will have the ability to see it and hear it.
Bees.
In both English and in Japanese.
Mitsubachi wa.
As well as having the picture dictionary show me a picture of a bee to make it easier for me to understand what it is I'm looking at. Another example for shirt.
Shirt. Shatsu.
And there's that picture for a shirt. Now I'll select back where I want my text from. And now the key part of the Immersive Reader is the ability for it to read the entire text out for me. I have settings that enable me to adjust how fast the reader will be, as well as the selection of either a male or female voice. Once I've selected my settings and I hit the play button.
Bees should not be able to fly. Its wings are too small to get its fat little body off the ground. The bee, of course, flies anyway because bees do not care what humans think is impossible.
And then I can stop that, and that is the Immersive Reader functionality in OneNote to help make reading comprehension easier and more accessible for all. I hope you found that tip useful, and I look forward to you sharing it around to all of your colleagues and friends and family, and I'll catch you in the next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.